Once again, that was Hot Shelly Ray. I Like to Dance. You're listening to 91.7 WNEC FM Henniker, New England College Radio. Oh.
Are you able to hear me?
Yeah, me too.
Okay. Oh, thanks.
Yeah,
that's what I needed.
I just turned it up. So,
hold on.
Hold on.
I'm not ready yet, but I am getting ready.
You're getting ready?
My fault.
Yeah, everything's your fault. Did I just... Oh, wait. No, I can't because I'm not on my account.
Hi, everyone. Okay, I'm good. You can pull up now.
All right, well...
My computer.
Okay, I guess we're doing this.
You're listening to 91.7 WNECFM Henniker, New England College Radio. This is Whose Show Is It Anyway?
A show based off... What? A show based off of ABC Television's old show, Whose Line Is It Anyway?
Which aired from 1998 to 2007.
As an inspiration, we have taken Whose Line Is It Anyway and made some changes to turn it into a radio show.
So, welcome to Whose Show Is It Anyways, where the points don't matter because we just suck as college kids and we're broke.
Wow, that's real funny.
Yeah, that wasn't supposed to be funny. Shut up. Oh my god.
It's hot.
Well.
No, it is. I agree.
I mean, you have a coat on. That's probably why.
Well, you know, you'd think that.
Well, we have the three amigops here. So,
three
I guess I'll
Cyclops.
I guess the what? I'll introduce. I'll start off with the introduction. Hi, I'm the 2016 spring semester production manager, John.
Music's a little loud, bud. But yeah.
Oh, God.
There
He's
you
always
go.
Complaining about. Okay.
What's your last name?
Just introduce yourself.
All right, fine. I'm the 2016 student, Eileen Kelly.
That works.
I am also a 2016 student, Sam.
That got nowhere. But you are listening to...
Who shows it anyway, as
no,
we introduce...
I was about to say 91.7
WNEC.
Oh, FM. Henniker.
New England College Radio. You're welcome.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you even go here?
Shut. Oh my god.
I just said I was a student.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Here, yeah.
We went over that. yeah, it's a show. It's very disorganized considering John and myself didn't start setting up until 9.
Yeah.
So we're pretty ill prepared.
Does not help.
Yeah, we're pretty ill prepared for this show, but we are ready to rumble. So, whose show is it anyway? Like we said, it's just like Whose Line Is It Anyway, and we have our own segments.
Yeah, but our segments are not as good. We just kind of suck.
We always have a warm-up segment, which is usually what?
Segway?
Oh, yeah.
Segway. So who wants to keep... I guess you are.
So we've kind of changed it a bit, but we kind of didn't. Like, we haven't had three hosts in a while, so what John and I have been doing, I have to explain it and not say it.
Basically, segue.
Yeah.
We talk about anything, just anything random. Anything all the time. Anything. Over and over. One person is going to write down all the topics we talk about, and in the end, the two people, now it's two, is going to have to...
and that's why I love this show.
Welcome to amateur radio station. I lost my train of thought. And the other two who are not writing it down basically have to recite all the topics that we talked about.
Yes.
In a way.
That's what we've been doing. We can keep doing that or just do segue.
Whatever you want.
Alright, we'll do the points thing because it's kind of fun.
The points thing?
Yeah, remembering it for points.
Sure, that'll work. That'll
so
work.
Whoever's
so,
writing it down,
all right,
is the host of Segway.
The sure. host of Segway. Well, I guess
we should update our guide with this information.
Yeah.
At some point.
Well, as you do that, I have a little song for everybody, personal favorite. Do you know what it is?
No.
Yeah, of course
is it
you don't.
Apache?
No, it's "Come With Me Now" by the Congos.
Walk with me now, I'm gonna take you down. Walk with me now, I'm gonna show you how. Walk afraid to lose control and caught up in this world. I've wasted time, I've wasted breath. I think I've thought myself to death. I was born without this fear. Now only this seems clear. I need to move, I need to fight. I need to lose myself tonight.
Walk with me now.
I move with my head, I open my mouth and it's something I've read. I've stood at this door before I'm told, but a part of me knows that I'm growing too old. Confused what I thought was something I felt. Confused what I feel was something that's real. I tried to sell my soul last night. Honey, you wouldn't even take a bite.
Far away, I heard him say.
So come with me now.
Yeah.
You have any? No?
You're listening nothing? To 91.7.
Oh, my God. WNEC FM Henniker,
New England College Radio.
Do we have to do that all
I miss
the time?
Our little sync together. Yeah.
Sure.
I've been playing it, man.
Really?
No, I haven't.
No, all you right, haven't.
So, but yeah, this is who shows it anyway. We're going to move on to our first segment called
Segway.
And just a re-explanation for anyone out there. The way Segway works is we just have a basic conversation, keeping track of the topics and where it goes and stuff like that. And then whoever's writing down like the topics, whoever's writing down the topics
is the host.
Is the host and the other two participants.
Shout out to Sal.
The other two participants. You're really distracting me here, bud. Listen.
The other two people talk. The other two to figure out if they can remember what they said.
Hey! You got it. Thank you.
Can
I have that back, by the way, what I just threw at you?
You're welcome.
Thank you. So, our first thing we want to talk about. Huh? Eh?
You said with porcupines.
Eh? First thing.
The porcupine.
Name something that comes after pork. Cupine. Yo, you ever see that Family Feud? My God. Steve's like, Steve goes to the guy.
Cupine.
Like, yeah, basically. Name something that comes after pork. Guy's like, cupine. He's like, what?
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, it's number one. It's number one. It's like, God.
Yeah.
I love that show.
That's funny.
Can you support me here?
Good answer.
What?
Wow, okay.
Okay. Well,
that's my favorite part of that show.
Is that our first?
I guess.
Yeah,
sure.
It is.
Family Feud. Family Feud specifically.
Okay, fine,
right?
Then. All right, you can do that.
Why did we start talking
We start
about?
Off with porcupines, but
porcupines
hey, man.
To Family Feud.
But there's a relevancy there. Yeah. What about, What's your favorite game show?
What's my favorite game show? I don't know. Didn't really grow up watching game
what
shows.
What about different? What about the different game shows? Like what?
What like about my, them?
I mean, my favorite one was The Wall.
The Wall?
Yeah, it was literally it was a game show where
did
families had to stand up on a line and a wall came at them and they had to fit into the slot.
That.
I forgot what it was called. I think it was called The Wall. I'm not sure.
I know
though.
What you're talking about.
I'm pretty sure it's what
you're hole in the wall.
Hole in the wall.
Oh, hole in the wall. That's what it was.
See, I grew up watching
it's
a
real
lot
thing.
Of cartoons.
It's a real thing.
Just, cartoons are my thing. So.
Yeah, I'm gonna say, Sam, your inner octogenarian is showing with the game show thing. But I don't know. I liked Dog Eat Dog. I guess that was good.
Oh, that was a great show.
Yeah, I remember
Dog
that.
Dog Eat Dog.
Yeah. See, yeah, got it. Hole in the wall.
So he pulls up a picture that literally no one else could see even on the live stream.
I don't even know.
he just pulled up the title screen like, yeah, see?
Ah. No, I can't.
Has a title screen.
It looks dopey. It looks just dopey. As dopey as it looks.
Yeah, there's a segment from the. No one can see it because it's a radio show. But
goodbye to the people who left the room.
But That was my favorite. But there's so many out there. There's Wheel of Fortune. There's
Jeopardy.
Who Wants to Be a Millionaire?
Who Wants to Be a Millionaire?
Are you smarter than a fifth grader?
Weakest Link.
That game.
That game was just. That game. I'm not gonna lie. That show was dumb to me. Like I didn't find that. And
they definitely like hired people that they kind of found on the street. There's no way that those people had like half those actual jobs.
I don't know. I was in like, what, sixth grade at the time, and I was like, I don't even know some of these questions.
I mean, some of them I don't know, but I think it's because the curriculum's changed.
Dang.
Price is Right. Did we talk about that already?
No, but would you like to? Okay, I have a thing. Can I talk about
Did you press a button over there,
yeah,
sir?
Yeah. I said something.
Oh. Nice job. Good job.
Dang.
No, Price is Right, I've got to say. apparently at some point they had a handicapped woman come on. In a wheelchair on The Price is Right. She got up, got The Price Right, and what she won was a treadmill. Like, legit.
Oh, yeah. I think I saw something like that.
Which is,
Shout out to Sal.
But, wow.
I don't think he'll hear it by the time.
I think it turned it down there. I'm sorry.
Oh, did you?
I know. I think they turned it up. I think they turned it up. Whatever. So, game shows. That's one. Am I even?
I'm browsing through a list of American game shows, and a lot of these I just do not know.
Well, probably because game shows were like prevalent in the 70s. Now people watch things like Kim Kardashian failing to like, I don't know.
I mean, I watch that.
Probably.
No, nowadays is what? There's like
for game shows?
No, for not for game shows. Just like what people watch in general. Like Keeping Up the Kardashians. There is like, I'm trying to think of some. There's some like the normal show or like Adventure Time or something like that.
Yeah, Adventure Time. Well, I've got to say, when it comes to sports, I've got to say on this campus in particular, there's a lot of people that watch soccer. Like a crazy amount of people that watch soccer, which I don't really understand, I'm going to be honest. Like, I liked playing it, but I think it's kind of... Yeah, it's kind of, I don't know, almost boring. Cause it's like, oh, look, they kicked it again. And
I don't know.
They lost possession again. Yeah.
It is like NASCAR. It's like NASCAR.
See, now, but I can understand because I used to, back in high school, I used to watch a lot of poker.
Did you watch the celebrity poker? Was it like actual
poker?
Okay,
no, that was amateur poker from then. No, I actually watched.
oh, no.
Did you vape while you watched
your
poker?
No, I didn't. Yo, relax.
Just wanted to know.
My God.
So you watched like actual, like I'm assuming like what, Texas Hold'em? Yeah.
Texas Hold'em, Omaha.
Did you play online while you were?
Yeah, I did.
Wow.
Too bad you couldn't. Too bad you couldn't.
Video game.
Play. Dude, play for money. You, America.
I used
America,
to play for money.
No, you. Online gambling was
my
like
brother,
illegal since like 2008. 2002, 2000. I don't know.
Oh.
But it was wit. I don't. I.
Then how did I...
I call BS. It used to be legal in America. However, a lot of sites, I'm not going to name them right now, but...
I played a game called Ark for money with my brother.
I mean, I used to play Call of Duty, but I didn't get I didn't get money from that.
ARK was a really old computer game, like Windows 95.
Oh.
Well, I was going to say, you can still win money from gaming. Like, there's a lot of tournaments that you actually can make real money on.
I mean, that is true. I mean, you can win money from chess tournaments. You can win money from magic tournaments.
But gambling, something about statistics that we shouldn't trust people.
I don't even know.
Why'd you
For my 21st birthday, I definitely would like to go to a casino. Bring like $100.
When's that happening?
Yep. Yeah,
$100 to the casino.
Hey,
that's it.
Do you remember when you won $5 in scratch tickets?
And then you won $20, then you lost it all?
$100.
I think I bought, first time it was like I bought one scratch ticket. And then I won $5 from that. Got hyped. And then I bought $1 $2 one, and then three $1 ones.
I don't know.
$1 $2, three $1 ones. And then I won like $3 from that. And then I bought three $1 ones. And then I got like $1 from that. And then I bought $1 from that.
I'm sorry.
$1. And then I just lost it all. So technically I could have made profit, but.
Well, you could have, but here's the thing is like, all I remember is everyone was just like, so John won $5 in scratch tickets. I was like, that's really neat. At the end of the night.
It was not the end of the night. It was not. It took me like a good 3 days.
Really? Well, I guess it was the next day then, because people told me within 24 hours that
it was
you
not
had 24 won.
Hours.
People had told me that people had told me within 24 hours.
Yeah, but people are dumb.
Well, I could have gotten it in an inaccurate timeline. Point being, within 24 hours, I heard John had a $5 scratch ticket that he won, and then like, yeah, and he's getting more tickets now.
$5 scratch ticket? You mean $5 from a scratch ticket?
Whatever.
Okay, we're not getting in this conversation because he's trying to like, I don't know what
like
this guy's doing.
Like,
over
what
here.
Are you doing?
I've already headbutted them.
All right, we're gonna use the list to get back to what we were talking to. I totally
gamble,
not paying
so
attention.
What? So
gambling.
What?
All right. Isn't there a casino on the way towards the camp we work at? I swear, there's a casino next
Oxford?
To the New Hampshire Speedway.
Maybe you gamble with people next to the.
What?
Three card Monty is illegal, but I love it.
What?
Three card Monty is illegal.
Like what?
You cannot do three card Monty. No.
I don't know that.
I've
never played
if
it.
If you go to Vegas, don't do it that openly, because I did make some money off of it. But
what?
I did three card Monty, not
Wait, what is three card Monty?
You have one queen. You have three cards. Someone says follow the queen. They flip the cards around.
Oh,
really
that.
Fast.
Sorry.
That's
okay.
Money.
Sorry.
You
I okay. I know what that is. I just didn't know the proper name for it.
It's usually rigged. Sometimes it's not.
I mean, sleight of hand, correct?
Yeah, well, there's two ways to do it. One is automatically fixed from the beginning. The other one's a matter of, it's how you throw it. It's in different angles. It's at different times. That way people think it's one card going, but it's actually the second card. It's mostly sleight of hand. Yeah.
So how much you make? I'm not going to ask you that, actually. I'm not going to ask you how much you made from that.
I can't say how much I made, John.
What about card tricks? How many card tricks do you know?
Not a lot. Back in high school, I used to know like 17 of them, and then I was like, now I know like one.
I only know the one, and it's not even a trick. It's like a storytelling about the whole like, you know.
Oh,
the four kings go to a hotel and get four different rooms. Did I show you that one night? No. You know of it,
it's
though?
Really common.
Oh. I'm boring.
The only one that I know is. It's basically mathematical, basically.
Yeah.
There's no, like, rigging. There's no sleight of hand to it. It's just like, oh, you need to know, remember this specific card, and then do some math. That's
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I know. No, I know what you mean. Yeah.
Most of what I know is, when I was, like, 12, I started to learn magic, and I can do, like, a few tricks. My favorite one actually involves some sugar and salt, and that's about it.
Yeah.
I'm not that great with magic tricks, to be honest, though. I'm not.
I don't
want to
be good with magic tricks. I just want to become like some sort of card dealer. Like
a dealer?
Like
just a dealer.
You want to be a dealer?
John wants to be a dealer.
I don't like dealers. They're really annoying, especially if they're a car dealer. but.
Sorry.
Something down. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I know you are. And she is too. So basically. I don't think I told you, but I told Eileen this, but I think like freshman or sophomore year of high school, I taught myself how to deal like your typical card dealer in a casino. So I was like, hey, how do you like do all that shuffly things? And like, oh, here's a link to this. So I was like, okay, there's a video. Basically teaches you how to do it. So I learned how to do it.
Okay.
Cool.
So
can you guys be happy for me or something?
Yeah. I am. Dang. So cool, John.
Quick jump back to the whole card tricks thing. I was the kid.
Yeah, that stuff when you were like, I was the kid.
Oh, there it goes. All right. I was the kid that I didn't know how to shuffle, didn't learn how to shuffle, so my parents got me one of those automatic shufflers.
Oh, no.
And I would put half the deck in one side, put half the deck in the other, and then every time it was my turn to shuffle, you'd just hear, as it, like, shuffled everything.
Yeah.
They did.
Yeah,
they
do.
They do.
They're pretty legit. Like, it's kind of weird.
Just so it's known. Anyway, I hate car dealers. Car dealers. Like, I went to a dealership because my...
You needed a car?
No. My father had to get his car fixed, and I had to pick him up. And I went there, and I was there for 25 minutes. This guy's trying to sell me a car. I'm like, I'm here to pick up my dad. He's like, I think you're a Jeep guy. I was like, I mean, I am, but, like, I'm here to pick up my dad. She's like, check out these Jeeps over here. And I was like, oh, my God. Like...
Oh, you said Jeep. I heard Jeep guy. I was like, well, he's not inaccurate.
Wow, thank you. Thank you very much. I appreciate the attempt.
Okay.
Have you ever been to a car dealership before?
I have. Oh, I was some news. I can't remember what was her name, but this was back when I lived in New Hampshire. Camera guy. All I saw was a guy holding a camera and a woman holding a microphone. And all of a sudden, I see myself on TV at the dealership. My dad was getting a car, and I guess something happened there. And they were like, oh, yeah, we're going to do like a report on it. So I was on TV for like a good 2 seconds. You could see me running across the room trying to grab a hot chocolate. Yeah.
So you were famous.
Yeah, I was on the news for
you're
a good 2 seconds.
You were famous.
For a good 2 seconds.
Maybe
my dad's
I
like, John, you're on the news.
What news?
I'm like, oh, man, what did I do? You just grabbed a hot chocolate, you moron. I'm like, whatever. I was like 6.
I was like 20.
I can picture Mini John running across the room with his Beyblade in his pocket.
Funny thing is, I probably did have a Beyblade at that time. Probably not
accuracy.
In my pocket, but no, that was a
That's
time
right.
when I had Beyblades, and the Beyblades like was
and
the
Beyblades
thing.
Had me.
No, Beyblades were the thing. I even had one of those plastic stadiums. I just brought it with me, and
you had it in your backpack.
No, you couldn't fit in your backpack. I had to like hold it, and then like 3 other kids would bring their own, and we would have to go to the cafe and like stuff it in like a corner or something because there would be no room in the classroom. And before recess, the 4 of us would like go to the cafeteria, grab our stadiums, and just have a little tournament outside during recess. That's all we would do.
True story. At our elementary school, they banned Beyblades because they caused so many fist fights.
I'd fight someone if they took my Beyblade. Oh, my God.
Oh, no, it happened. That and Pokemon.
They are.
If I got mad at someone, I wouldn't fight them if they had a Beyblade. We'd have a Bay battle.
Bay battle?
I did. One, I did not hear Bay battle. Two, even if I heard Bay battle, I'm thinking of John facing off against other John.
Wait a minute. Bay battle. Is it when people fight over their bay? They're fighting over the loss of their Beyblade, or they're fighting with Beyblades?
I'll take C, Regis.
I'll take D. That wasn't funny.
Sorry.
Saying you'll take D is probably the...
I'll take
one.
D.
Shut
You're listening
up.
To 91.7 WNEC FM Henniker, New England College Radio.
Radio. I hate this segment.
About P?
Don't stop. Don't...
Shut
scratch
up.
Your
oh my
beard
gosh.
Against the mic.
Yo, it actually kind of hurts.
You're so
like,
scummy.
I don't have much going on, but like I have just a little bit enough that like when I actually do this, it actually hurts.
Wait, let me. Yeah, nothing.
No, nothing.
No, nothing. Although I've hit my nose against it a number of times in my life, so
I mean,
that counts.
Oh my God, I actually heard that. I actually heard that.
Wait, do
okay.
it.
Pink. Like the hair come out.
Yeah.
Of the pop filter. By the way, everyone.
Uh-oh.
Hey, we're back. Hey, by the way, everybody. Yeah, my beard hair keeps getting stuck in the pop filter of the microphone. I bet everyone in their car is like,
don't make out
simultaneously
it.
In 5 seconds because of the delay are just going to be like, oh!
Did you say,
Eileen,
don't
channel.
Make out with it?
Yeah, don't make out with it.
Hey, you want to fight?
Have you seen?
Yo, what happens if like your future partner has a huge thing for pop filters?
My future partner?
Yeah.
because of this show.
No, no,
bring
she's
it.
Like, you don't know, like first dates. So
I'm
what are
single.
You, so what are you into? Oh, I'm into pop filters.
There's a lot of filters we could pop together.
Hey, thanks
okay.
for the notes.
Oh, well, okay, well, I have our next song, The Seeker by The Who.
To get what I'm after till the day I die. I asked Bobby Dylan, I asked the Beatles, I asked Timothy Leary, but he couldn't help me either. They call me the Seeker. To get what I'm after till the day I die. People tend to hate me 'cause I never smile. As I ransack their homes, they wanna shake my hand. Focusing on nowhere, investigating miles. I'm a seeker, I'm a really desperate man.
Shot of balance, but you're still making noise, making a pose. Tell me what to do, now the tank is dry, now this wheel is flat.
And that was Weezer's My Name is Jonas. No, you're not on the mic, but I can turn you on. No, I can't. Wrong.
It, though. It's good. I'm over here now. So I just found out that this morning when Andrew got me tea, it was laxative tea. That's really weird.
So you basically took laxatives.
Yeah, I took a laxative tea. I'm using your mic. God. All right, she's taking her mic back. Give me my... Hello. All right, turn mine up a bit because it's not as loud as the others. I have more XLR. That's good. All right, thanks.
Laxative tea, huh?
Laxative. Yeah, I had a laxative tea.
Plums are laxatives.
I avoided a laxative tea.
I guess we're moving on from Beyblades to plums very randomly.
I'm pretty sure both of you know my story of plums.
Oh my gosh, no.
No?
I don't need to know your story. Wait, are we continuing with Segway?
Yeah, we are.
All right.
I've been writing it all down. I hope
not. This game has been going on for like a good half an hour.
There you go. Thanks. That was my cue to him.
It's really weird.
So porn, huh?
Yeah. Oh my god. I heard that in my... Oh, that was gross.
Yeah. Everyone, you're listening to
91.7
WNEC FM Henniker,
New England College Radio.
You're listening to whose show is it anyways?
Seriously, whose show is it anyways?
Oh, did you just say who? Did you enter the show? A show based off ABC.
Stop.
I'm
kidding.
Okay, let's
So
we actually,
plums.
Do we actually have? No. I was gonna say, do we have listeners outside of the ones that we know of right now? Do we have listeners
online,
that would call
maybe.
In at all?
Probably.
You know?
Yeah.
I mean, I could just ask my sister to call.
I know.
In.
I've
Apparently
got.
She's
I've got people listening.
Well, I'm just sitting here. I'm like, I wonder if people were to call in, because if we were to talk about that girls that are a mile away from you.
So if you have a girl. Who's into you and she lives like about a mile from you.
Let's talk about.
Be sure to call us and let us know.
Hold on. 603-428-2278. No. I think we're going good with the whole plum story.
Okay.
Because I don't want to jump from plums to. I'm not going to remember it. I want points, man. I want points.
I want points.
Let's stay in plums. I ate a plum once.
I did too in the third grade.
Yeah. Go ahead and talk about it.
And freshman year of high school? Freshman year of high school. There's something...
The very year.
On the fifth day!
It was a vintage
plum.
Of
my freshman year of
no,
high
I just
school.
No, I just know some specific
I
details.
I ate a plum!
Alright, in the third grade, I ate a plum, and I basically shat myself in class.
Can you even say that?
Shat?
Is that even allowed?
I made a dump. I pooped my pants.
We might as well make another dump for the radio for the sake of I'm not sure if you can actually say that.
Can I say that word? S-H-A-T.
I think if you call it chat as in
Hold on.
C-H-A-T for the cat, the French cat, I'm sure you can get away with it.
Technically not.
What time is it?
Or Shatner, yeah, that works too.
It's 4 of 10. 4 of 10.
Well, I mean, both our program manager and assistant program manager are listening, so if they do give a shit, we'll find out.
Yeah. I'm not gonna make that.
Then don't ask.
All right.
So I guess we found out.
So I mean, there's a difference between what I said and what you said.
S H I T.
No, there's one
S H A T.
I S
past.
Oh, shat.
Whatever. Yeah.
Shat.
Yes.
Yeah. Sure.
Okay, so I basically shat my pants.
Okay,
and we got back from recess. Okay.
I like how we're continuing the story.
Do you want to hear the story?
Yeah, I do.
All right.
No, you don't.
Go
on. Third grade, we get back from recess.
Uh-huh.
SSR, sustained silent reading. After that.
Wait, what?
SSR.
Sustained silent reading.
Or super silent reading. Either
super
way.
I'm going to find a different song that doesn't drop so much. I'm sorry.
I mean, that drop has been convenient.
As
in an inappropriate.
So you want me
way.
To continue with it?
Sure.
Okay.
But either way,
amateur
I get
radio.
Back from I get back from recess. SSR, we're done reading. We're continuing the class, and all of a sudden, my teacher just stops, just sniffs the air, is like, "Does anyone smell dog poop?" I'm like, "Who stepped in dog poop?" Because I didn't know I shat my pants. All I did was just like fart a little bit, and it was wet. I don't know. I thought it was just a wet fart, and I was like, all right, so just a wet fart.
Before you wrecked yourself.
You knew it was wet.
You can have wet farts without shatting yourself. I'm just saying.
So this all has to do with the plum story?
Yeah.
Yes, because he ate plums. Because
I had plums for lunch.
All right, go on.
I packed a lunch with plums. And so, like, everyone's checking their shoes, their clothes. And they're like, no, we don't smell it. I check my shoes. No, I don't smell it. Like, I stand up, too. I stand up and smell my shoes. Okay, no, they're good. I sit back down. There's a little, like,
ew!
I'm like, ah!
So when you sat down, there was a little...
No!
No, not even.
No, it was not.
Hold on.
I felt some warm spots all over my butt. And I'm like, dang. So my teacher looks at me. He's like, John? I'm like, I think that's me. And everybody thought, did you poop dog poop for like a good 2 seconds? And I'm telling him, you can't poop dog poop. So the teacher's like, okay, use the bathroom, because we had one of those bathrooms in the classroom. So go to the bathroom and wipe yourself. Okay. And I'm going to call your dad, and like, so he can bring you some extra underwear and pants. Her desk is like 2 feet away from the bathroom, so I can hear what's going on. It's like, hey, Mr. Bay? He's like, yeah. Do you think you can bring a fresh pair of underwear and pants for your son, John? He's like, what happened? He pooped his pants. My dad's like, what? Yeah, he pooped his pants. I'm like, oh. Like, he's currently
Stop
in the bathroom.
Tickling me.
Like, taking care of the situation. Everything's fine. And he didn't disrupt the class. I was like, okay. 20 minutes later, my mom shows up. It's like, knock, knock. Hey, John.
Yeah?
Like, yeah?
Yeah.
He's like, what happened? He's like, I pooped my pants. It's like, okay. And then she tells me to open the door. I open the door. Can you two, like, stop for, like, 2 seconds? I'm trying to tell a story here, and you're, like, disrespect.
It's like, tickling me.
So, no. And then she opens the door, slides in a plastic bag. It had extra underwear and pants. Mind you, it was SpongeBob underwear, so I was like, good job. So...
No. You have to do the voice. You had the voice last time you did the whole paper, like, plastic bag thing.
Fine. She's like, knock, knock. I'm like, you're like, John? She's like, yeah. It's like, are you okay?
Yeah.
What happened?
I pooped my pants.
It's like, okay. I hear some laughing on the outside. It's like, is everything okay? He's like, yeah. It's like, I wiped myself. Like, okay, I have some pants here for you. I'm like, okay. They hand me the bag.
I'm trying to make a plastic noise.
That's not how that works.
The thing is, I'm trying to take off my pants and my underwear at the same time, but I don't take off my shoes. And I have some giant, like, those giant Nike white shoes.
Did they light up?
No.
Oh, okay.
Well, they wouldn't for much
those
longer.
Those weren't Skecher days. So, I'm trying to take them off. But you know how, you know, poop is on one side of the underwear, and, like, when you fold them, when you take out your pants, like, improperly, they can be inside out. So, and I'm on the floor too. So I'm like dragging my poop stain and poop all over the floor.
Oh, I didn't know
and
this
I'm like,
part.
Oh God.
Yeah, no.
No, real. I told you this part. I know for a fact.
No,
I did.
He tells everyone.
And I'm
this
trying
part.
To like take my. I'm trying to take off my pants with my while keeping my shoe on, because I didn't want to take off my shoes, because I didn't know how to tie my shoes back then. So like
in third grade.
Yeah, no, I didn't know.
That timing was
that year,
spotless.
That year was, like, after that, I was like, yeah, I need to learn how to tie my shoes, so I learned how to tie my shoes. And so I put on my pants. Boy, I finally got them off, and I had to, you know, take some toilet paper and wipe the floor. And I came out of class, and he's like, you want to go home, John? I'm like, no. Okay.
Wow.
Class just
presumably. Let it be known, everyone, John Bay is not a quitter.
No, but
the
thing
and
is,
this is your what teacher?
Is, this is my third grade teacher.
Third grade teacher. What was his name?
Her, but I can't.
What was her name?
Miss Rodney.
Did she ever look at you the
Miss
same?
Miss Rodney?
I don't know, but when she hugged me, because I was leaving, I was sweaty. And basically, I was a tall kid during that time. My head was up to her chest.
Her bosoms.
Like, yeah, basically. Ooh. And she like took my sweaty head and just bang. So I'm technically motorboating this. I'm motorboating it, but she's like getting sweat all over her shirt. I'm like, what are you doing? Like, this is good for me, but this is, how is this beneficial to you?
So were you wearing glasses back then?
This is my teacher.
Did you have glasses on back then?
No.
You didn't have glasses.
I got glasses in the 7th grade.
Okay. I was just picturing the imprint that seventh, would be on her on her clothes as you were like, did like it peel off? Like,
are you getting sexually interested in this, Sam? You're a little specific.
I thought my teacher was like sexually interested. I'm like, Miss Rodney, you're like 30, and I'm like 10.
And I can't really get it up yet, so.
Mrs. No, miss.
You know what they say. Half your age plus.
No! That's wait, still older
what?
Than me. It's half your age plus
you
7.
You know what they say.
I was
well,
10.
For that to work, wouldn't it be like half your age minus 5?
Still.
Hey, half your age minus 5 if you're
she was 30 or 40. I don't know her in age. I had a crush on her.
I don't know
it.
Her age.
Half your age minus 10 then.
Shut
up, Miss Rodney.
Thanks for letting me motorboat
if
you.
She's still interested.
Oh my god.
John, would you eat another plum for her? Would you do it again?
I mean, if she's into that.
Yo, if someone called right now as Miss Rodney, it would be absolutely hilarious.
I mean, I lived in New Hampshire at the time, so.
Where?
Miss Rodney, if you're out there, call. Like, I did.
No,
I'm kidding. That was me.
I know that was you. You had your phone out and everything. Oh my god, that was funny. Oh yeah, no, I had a crush on her and I pooped my pants in front of her.
I think that ends
true
segue
love.
For today.
True
yeah, that's love.
Love. Yeah,
that's love.
I think that ends
so,
segue for tonight.
So do you want to try to recount everything you've
said? Do you
said?
Think we could recall everything?
The first thing was like game shows.
No.
Hold on, first off, I'm going to make a score sheet. It's going to be John. Actually, I'm going to call him Plum Boy.
Plum Boy.
No, actually, I'm sorry.
Seeger.
PB&J. Plum Boy John.
It's going to be Plum Boy with an I. And then there's going to be Sam. All right. Let's go.
So, first thing was
Seeger something.
What?
No.
No, I know game shows was second.
Game shows was definitely there for a solid large amount.
It was not the first thing, though.
No, it was not. It starts with an I, does it?
No.
H?
No.
F?
No.
G?
No.
Just
go through
the
whole
album.
Yeah. Z?
No.
X?
C? No.
Y?
No.
W?
No.
That's not even in reverse. I think I got those back.
Like, yeah, you did.
Okay, it's out of order.
C?
Okay, no, you said C. Z. No, it's Z, Y, X, O, U. What did you say?
C?
No.
D?
No.
E?
No.
A?
No.
B?
No.
H?
No.
I?
No.
J?
No.
K?
No.
Elemental P?
Last one.
S.
P?
Yes.
Porn?
No, surprisingly not porn.
Uh-oh. Well, we lost our listener baseness because you said... Oh, nope, it's back.
P, kidding. P, private, no. P, what? What's the second letter? Give
o.
us that. P-O? Porn.
No.
P-O.
Pompons?
No.
Poop?
No.
We'll just say John doesn't get the points. We talked about car dealers. I know that.
Yeah, we talked about car dealers.
It went from
okay.
game shows...
So, if you're not going to do what came first, what came second?
Game shows.
Game shows.
Okay, you're both correct there.
Okay.
What was the first one, then? What was the first one?
Porcupine.
Porcupine!
Oh!
Family Feud.
Wow.
Porcupine.
I didn't remember that much either.
All right, third one is... Did we get into specific?
I bought.
Was
it leading through the paper? It's kind of hard. Like,
Family Feud game, the wall
it's behind it. Like,
fine, I'll put it behind it. Jesus.
All right.
Was the third one the wall?
No, that was still game shows. Hole.
I mean, well,
we got into specifics.
We got into specifics, and you actually were correct. But it's
wall.
Up to Sam to say whether or not
hole in the wall.
No.
Holes.
No.
Weakest Link, Family Feud. No.
It was Family Feud. Hardly counts, but we'll go with it.
So I don't get the point?
Go no, dancer, go dancer.
You got it, you got it.
Oh, okay.
Hey, Plum Boy.
You should get a tattoo. I'm not gonna get a tattoo of Plum Boy on my... Oh, my
Plum God. Boy.
Well, I mean, you could tattoo a plum
get it,
on your
get
ass.
Get it on your bum, yeah.
Yo.
And then have Miss Reynolds kiss it one day.
Reynolds?
What was her name?
Miss Reynolds.
Rodney? I don't know.
Oh, Miss Rodney.
Her name's now Miss Reynolds for the sake
of
anonymity.
If she's into,
I tattooed this plum for you.
Eating booty. Sure.
Would you like her to?
Groceries,
yeah.
Like groceries, like plums.
Oh. You guys aren't funny, you know that?
You're not funny.
Dude, superheroes. I want to make a superhero called Plum Boy now. Yo. Who saves Miss Rodney?
Oh, Plum Boy, let me give you a big hug.
You've got to hear the droplets coming off.
See, Plum Boy, his like, superpowers is just literally sharding on his enemies.
That's the droplets coming off.
You know, explosive diarrhea, basically.
What? Do you...
have you guys ever seen Full Metal Alchemist?
He drinks laxative tea.
Have you guys seen Full Metal Alchemist? No.
Wait. No.
God. Basically, there's a character who uses alchemy to control the oxygen, and just makes bombs on air.
Oh.
Or bombs on.
Plum Boy.
Basically, I do that, but with poop.
I think John and I forfeit.
So you don't want to try after that?
What was that? What was that then? I give up on that one.
It went from Family Feud to game shows, to
Porcupine.
No, it started with Porcupine.
I know, but it was like
Family Car Dealers.
No, that was not next.
Beyblades.
Huh?
Magic?
No.
Beyblades?
No.
Card tricks.
No.
Gambling.
No.
Casinos.
No.
Are you serious?
I'm pretty sure that was more. I think that was after.
Vaping.
No.
Did you say vaping?
Yeah.
No.
I don't know.
Never discussed that. No, it's another game show.
Wheel of Fortune?
No.
Jeopardy?
No.
Hold the Wall?
No. There's an old white man that should be dead.
Who Wants to Be a Millionaire?
Are you smarter than a fifth grader?
No. Jeff Foxworthy is not
right?
An old white man.
Yeah, I don't know.
The Price is Right?
Yes, it's The Price is Right.
Dang.
We talked about that?
Yeah, we did.
Drew Carey's not that old.
The handicapped woman? No, that
Drew Carey hosts it now.
Yeah, Bob Barker used to hold it. Yeah.
He should be dead. Yeah. He's not dead?
I don't think he is.
Bob Barker, bless your soul. It's We're sorry for like cursing you. All right, knock on wood for Bob Barker. Same time. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
No.
Okay,
stop.
Wow. Thanks, guys.
Next one was like, was it another game show?
No. It was a general topic.
Gambling.
No.
Car tricks.
Magic.
No.
It's whaling.
Give us a hint. First letter.
S.
Sharding.
No.
Shoot.
So we were talking about Price is Right, and that
led to
what's the relativity in this? Was it just a jump?
It was it was kind of a jump. I'm gonna be honest.
A weird jump.
Yeah.
John's giggity life.
Sex
with S.
No. Well, it does begin with an S, but no.
Straight up.
I don't think we talked about that.
We talked about porn.
We might have talked about it when the mics are off, really, but
I give up.
I give up.
All right. So it was sports.
Sports. Oh, okay, okay, okay.
Card tricks.
After that.
Card tricks. Gambling.
No.
Card tricks.
No.
Magic?
No.
When did we talk about men?
Did we ever talk about
give
anything?
Us the first letter. First letter.
N.
Nature? Oh. Nature.
Nudity. What?
Nude? Nude. Ned. What?
What? Was it another jump?
No. It's related to
sports.
Wait,
what was the last one I forgot? That was sports.
Sports.
Sports. This is
New York?
I think this was that segment where I wasn't paying attention. Scout camp?
No!
That starts to N, right?
Yeah, no.
Okay, it's an acronym. And it's N-A...
North America.
No.
Oh my god. Sports? Jesus.
Sports.
And sports to N-A... What?
Do you want me to just...
Yeah,
I give up.
NASCAR. It was briefly mentioned.
Oh my god. That was briefly
it was like
mentioned. Was the next topic poker? Was the next topic poker?
No.
Gambling. Card tricks.
Magic.
Gambling. Card tricks.
It was not gambling, no.
Card tricks.
Dealing.
It was a specific thing from John, though.
Poker.
No.
Online, no. Watch,
it was
watching,
a personal story from John.
Watching, used to
learning
watch.
Learning how to become a dealer. How to shuffle like a dealer.
So watch, he played,
magic
he
tricks.
Played online dealing. Online gambling.
No.
No.
I didn't gamble
online poker.
No.
Give us the first letter.
I give up.
S.
S?
Yeah.
After NASCAR, Beyblades. No,
no, Beyblades is way later.
You could say it's related to gambling.
Shuffling?
No.
What? I give up.
Shuffler?
It was your personal story about scratch tickets.
Oh, that was way.
I forfeit
that was
for the next.
That.
I forfeit
that was
the whole
way
thing.
After. Okay, fine. Next one was it gambling?
Beyblades.
It was gambling.
Gambling. Card tricks is after that.
Card
tricks is after
magic
gambling.
Tricks.
Technically speaking, that came after this next thing.
Magic tricks?
No.
Shuffler?
What?
No. We were talking about
card dealing.
Yes.
Casinos? Okay.
Well, I mean, it was about
the card tricks.
Wait, John, did you say car dealing or card dealing?
Car.
Yeah, it was car dealing.
Hey. It's the longest segue we've ever done.
I remember, because I was like, are you trying to say car de or car?
Yeah. So after that?
About Sam's story about how he was like haggled, like being hassled
shuffler.
Into.
My shuffler. Right? No.
That came after this next thing, and it was part of it. But
wait, so we just did card tricks? Sorry,
so
I was
magic tricks?
Stuff on
yes,
Facebook for
magic tricks.
Then Sam Shuffler.
Shuffler.
I'll count that because it did come directly after.
Hey, Sam
accepted my friend request. Hey.
Yeah.
Then what
do
we have
now.
After?
Oh.
Perfect stop, right?
Oh my gosh.
SpongeBob? What's it start with?
The next thing starts with a B.
Beyblade.
There you go. I'll give it to both of you.
Even though I said it first.
Hey.
Why the hell not?
It's because your last name already starts with it.
No, it doesn't.
Doesn't
it's
mean
B-A-E.
You can fight me.
It's in a B-A-Y.
Dude, I wish we could have okay, Beyblades, so and then in the middle of a raid show, if we get into a disagreement, we have to Beyblade battle. Like, have to.
Next one.
I'm just going to hear, yes!
Next one.
Like,
next one.
What did we first talk about when we got back from
porcupines.
Break?
Magic.
When we got back from
magic?
Break?
Like when we got back from like our little like water break.
Oh, that.
Oh, porn.
I'll count it. I didn't write it down.
Oh, the camera?
Camera? Remote?
Cam girls.
Camera remote? Cam girls?
No, after we talked about immediately
I'm so
after.
Sorry, whoever's listening to this right now in their car like, what is this show?
All right, next one.
What is the next one?
Give us the first letter.
L.
I give up.
Love.
No.
Lifestyle. Living.
No.
Lifting.
I give up.
Laxative teas.
Oh.
Laxative teas.
That's
laxative
right, because I drank a laxative tea, and I didn't know
then
it.
Then it got to plums, and how I pooped myself in this.
Yes.
And then now
plums.
You're plum boy.
And that's
wow,
it.
We went through the
that's
whole
it.
Thing. So
I'm pretty
won.
Sure I won that.
All right, host, who
yeah,
won?
You did. That would be plum boy.
Plum boy won. All
how many
right.
points did I have?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
How many did Sam have?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh!
Not bad.
You kind of suck.
Wow. Kind of.
It's better than sharding.
I messed up
plums.
There. Oh,
oh
God.
My God. My sister just texted me saying, what is this show? Shout out to Christy. Thanks for listening in.
You know, that's a really great question. What
did
is this
I
show?
Do something weird with the camera here?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I did. Oh, God. Okay, we're back. All right.
So, welcome to, and since my sister just, like, tuned in, welcome to Whose Show Is It Anyways? Basically, a show based off of ABC's television old show, Whose Line Is Anyways, which aired from 1998 to 2007. And as an inspiration, we've taken Whose Line Is It Anyways, and we made some changes and turned into a radio show. So, welcome to Whose Show Is It Anyways, where money matters to us, but the points don't matter because we don't have money.
Financial aid.
And we're gonna be moving on to a new segment right after a short song break, which I'm gonna queue up this time.
Whatever.
I'm gonna play it off your computer though. Ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna be listening to a song called. Never mind. We're gonna be listening to a song.
You picked. I could pick something right now.
No, I got it. We're gonna listen to a called song. Cool Kid by Echo Smith. Shout out to Megan Poldy, by the way.
Thank you. not really her style. And they all got the same heartbeat, but hers is falling behind. Nothing in this world could ever bring them down. Yeah, they're invincible, and she's just in the background. And she says, I wish it I
for forgave, and I won't forget. Know what we've seen, and him at last. Now in some way, strong, and use my head alongside my heart. So tame my flesh and fix my eyes. A tethered mind freed from the lies.
91.7
WNEC FM Henniker New England College
Radio.
Why is
radio?
That's playing. Okay, fix it.
So,
you're listening to Whose Show Is It Anyway?
A show derived from Whose Line Is It Anyways?
Say it so people can hear it.
A show based off of ABC's Whose Line Is It Anyways?
Which aired from 1998 to 2007.
That wasn't me. Sorry. As an inspiration, we have taken Whose Line Is It Anyway and made it into a radio show.
So, welcome to Whose Show Is It Anyways? Where the points don't matter because the points are as useless as us.
Deep.
Wow.
So, on that note, we just completed Segway. Plum Boy won 8-5. Bravo.
Yeah. Suck it, Sam. What?
Sorry.
Okay.
What do you guys want to do? Our segue options are, we could try to do one of these.
I'm a huge fan of questions.
We could do questions. We could try one of the things on the sheet here. We can do speed dating.
I feel like
this is the last show.
Internship ends like on the 17th, so we have to have a show next week.
Mm-hmm. No, the show requirement ends. We don't have to.
So do we want to skip questions? Man, I'm going to go bald when I'm old.
I'm going to go bald too.
I'm not.
Lucky
get out.
Maybe I'll get a head tattoo.
We'll do quick questions.
Tattoo.
All right, questions. The way that questions work. Yeah, you guys okay with that? Questions?
We will commute. Basically, it'll be a one-on-one thing. Okay, basically, questions. It's going to be a one-on-one thing, or we can do a three-way. Doesn't matter to me.
Oh.
Well.
Shut up.
Nudge, you offered. I'm tempted.
But, questions. A conversation, and we basically have our own conversation, and the only way we can respond is with questions. Anything else, anything that's not a question, is going to be a point towards the other person. So, do you want to pull up music for us?
Yep, if you turn down my music. Wow. Or you can do that.
Drop. Just a huge drop.
Drop the bass.
That
one? No one?
No.
Nope.
We can make our own music.
No, we're not going to do that. I mean, I can pull up some.
That's the worst
I've
ever heard.
I just. All right. So the way questions work is questions fit a theme. We have a bunch of music here, and we use the music as a. Can't use that one. We use the music as kind of like the setting for the scenario for our segment here called Questions.
Do we want to listen to some K-pop? Me neither. Continue.
I already threw together a thing. I'm already playing some music. So for our first one, who are going to be the two questioneers? We'll switch off.
I'm willing to volunteer for the first one.
All right. So let's do you two.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And I'll be the judge of who messes up. And then whoever messes up swaps out for
the remaining person.
Yeah, the other person.
Yeah.
Cool? Wow, there's a cough button for that, buddy.
So I'm trying to figure out, we're just going to base questions off the song.
Off the song.
The song will
take
kind
the song
of
and fit it to a scenario.
We'll create the environment we're going to be in, and then within that environment, we're going to create the event.
Okay, I'll figure it out.
We'll let John lead this first one.
It's all right? Pretty easy.
All right.
Easier done than said.
All right, ready, and...
I, like, basically switched the phrasing.
Yeah. Yeah, you did.
I switched the phrasing. No, I switched the phrasing on
On purpose? On purpose. Oh, boy, I can see this taking a bunch of really weird places.
Is that a no? Yeah, sorry.
I don't know.
All right.
Are you... Oh.
Actually, go back to the other one.
Okay, fine.
Do you want to start it or do you want me to start it?
I can start it.
Okay.
All right. How much are you charging?
How much do you want for it?
What are you offering?
Why'd you have to ask me that? Isn't it right here?
What's right there? What are you offering?
Why can't you use your eyes?
I can't see right now.
Why can't you see me?
I don't have my glasses on.
Why didn't you bring your glasses?
Wait.
Yes.
Suit and ties. Suit and ties.
What brings you to this dark and horrid place?
What?
Why'd you ask me to come to this dark and horrid place?
You received my invitation?
Doesn't everyone have a Gmail?
Did you not receive it through Yahoo?
Who uses Yahoo anymore?
Are we friends on MySpace?
Would you like to be?
Will you call me Daddy?
Will you please shut up?
Do you know what this place is?
How could I not know? Do you know what
me?
This place is?
Could you tell me?
Sorry. I'm just gonna pass. The music just made me fucking laugh.
Welcome to the...
Sorry! Sorry!
It's fine. It's fine. All right.
Do you know why I'm shaking?
You're shaking?
Can we not talk about this?
Do you like the new music?
What music?
Have you never been to a Denny's before?
Aren't we the bomb squad?
Can we say bomb on air?
That's a good question. We're gonna let it pass for now. I'm on the bomb squad? Segment's gonna just...
Can you hand me that pliers?
Did you not bring the pliers?
Where's your toolbox?
Wasn't it your toolbox?
Can you not see that we have to defuse a bomb right now?
That's a bomb?
The thing that that looks like a mysterious bacon cheeseburger.
You're disarming a bacon cheeseburger?
Are you stupid?
What did you ask for?
Are you my waiter?
Can I take your order?
Who are you?
Why aren't you defusing the bomb?
Why are you telling me what to do?
Boom.
No! Oh god, not this.
So it's between John and Eileen now.
Do you know my name?
You know how dumb that was?
That was a question. That was a question. He's good. He's good.
Who's a you?
Aren't I controlling you?
Are you player one?
Why are you talking back?
Have you heard of interactive gaming?
What happened to your accent?
Haven't you heard of Princess Peach?
Weren't you Mario like 2 seconds ago?
Would you like me to be Mario?
Can you do both?
Doesn't that cost extra?
Do you think a guy like me should be worried about money?
Do you think you have enough money?
How much are you charging?
Do you know how many coins to insert?
Where do I insert?
Have you seen the insert here button?
Where's that at?
Oh my gosh.
Could one say it's located below you?
But there... Do you see anything below me?
Does anyone see anything? Really?
What kind of a question was that?
Okay, I'm
Wouldn't it
that
be
one.
The kind of well?
Sorry.
Wouldn't it be the kind of question that has a question mark at the end?
Are you trying to be a smart aleck on me?
Sorry, I didn't know what just happened. All of a sudden, you just did that
sorry.
Motion.
I did that confused. Motion to move my mic. I guess we're going to move on. We'll just same people, because it was my bad. But this is good. He gets all a right. kick out of this one. Ready?
Do you have my items?
Would you like your items?
How much are they gonna cost?
Do you have the money?
Do you think a guy like me should be worried about money?
Have you ever seen a millionaire wearing a Walmart vest?
Isn't there something going on right now?
Wouldn't you like to know?
That was a stupid question.
That's not even a question.
I know.
All right.
Yeah, no, it is. Wasn't that painful?
I don't even know what I was talking about, to be
that
honest.
That was, I wasn't keeping track, but I don't know who would have won that segment. But the points don't matter, so it doesn't matter.
What?
You're listening to Whose Show Is It Anyway, a radio show based off of Whose Line Is It Anyway, where the points do not
Shout
matter.
Out to Mr. Wagner.
Shout out to Mr. Wagner, who has entered the room.
Say.
But yeah. Anyway, we're going to flop over some tunes. We're going to go to our next segment right after this. Thanks for listening to Whose Show Is It Anyway on WNEC 91.7 FM Henniker,
New England College Radio.
Hey. Should we do a
shout-out?
Shout-out.
Go ahead.
So, big shout-out to Robert Carbonell. Carbonell? I think I'm pronouncing that right.
We'll say that.
So, hello from Brazil. Hey, hello from America.
Hello from New Hampshire.
Hello from Reader Studio.
Reader Studio and Henniker, the only Henniker in the world.
That's true. The only Henniker on Earth is actually the
I'm glad you think our questions game is fun. We'll definitely play some music for you.
Thanks for listening. If you're on the Facebook, we put a link for you to view the stream. We have a YouTube stream of our studio. You can watch that and see the fun and interesting things that happen in the studio between songs. But moving on, John, we have a song.
We have a song. This song is the Sugar Hill Gang, Apache.
Thank you.
Like Kimo Sabe, of course it's me, a better known as the Master G. A fucking new squad, sense the danger, when it's stung by the rapping ranger. Had a little talk with my medicine man, he said get them squads fast as you can. To all you girls that wanna join my tribe, just move to my rhythm and feel my vibe. Put up a fuss in the end, you'll agree. But when you come inside my TV, as I said before, you can sense the danger when you're stung by the rapping ranger. With Silver and I take a ride, all you teams better step aside. I stay with squads, then run away.
Ho!
Silver is what I'll say.
Ho!
Kimasada got down, took off his mask. He kicked off the shoes and did the monster mash. Tonto came along, saw what was happening. His head began to bop and his foot started to pat and go slam, dunk, do the jerk. And with the mic is how my smoke signals work. They were jamming off a record that said it best. Now what you hear is not a test.
get attached. Shoot, I'm stepping in harder this year. Yeah, be rapping in harder this year. Watch me as I gravitate. Ha 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 ha. We gon' ghost town, this Motown with your sound. You in the blink, gon' bite the dust. Can't fight with us. With your sound, you kill the ink. So don't stop, get it until you chatty head. Watch the way I navigate.
Speaking of feeling young and being high, you're listening to 91.7 WNEC FM Henniker, New England College Radio. We're not high. That was just a joke. This is whose show is it? Cue me up. Is it?
Oh my God.
Is it? Who?
Anyway, sorry.
Whose show is it anyways?
We got another person who's been hanging out with us the entire show and finally found a microphone for him. Hi, CJ.
Hey, what's up, man?
What's up? Welcome to Whose Show Is It Anyway? Where the points don't matter. Why are you here?
Because I'm broken. I have nothing better to do with my life.
Our intros are getting increasingly depressing.
Yeah, probably.
Oh, you want to do an actual one?
No.
Not too late.
No, we're not. Oh, good lordy lord.
You're listening to 91.7 WCFM Henniker, New England College Radio.
This is Whose Show Is It Anyways?
A show based off ABC Television's old show, Whose Line Is Anyway?
Which aired from 1998 to 2007.
As an inspiration, we've taken Whose Line Is It Anyways, and we've made some slight changes to turn it into a radio show.
Welcome to Whose Show Is It Anyway, where the points don't matter, because we don't even matter.
Wow, our intros are just getting...
That was dark.
I'm sorry, I can't do any better.
Sorry,
Can you stop bleeding?
What
everywhere?
Did
you do? He stabbed himself.
After the last, our last segment when we put on Apache, I was dancing to it, and I totally nailed myself in my face with my own fist.
Oh, was it your own fist? I thought you nailed it with the remote.
No.
So, I guess while we were playing Apache, my sister texted me, "Who requested this song? It sounds like a middle school dance."
I am practically exactly a middle schooler, it. So.
But anyway, you're listening to Whose Show Is It Anyway?
Whose Show Is It Anyways?
Next segment, I think it's a good time for speed dating just to slow down the night. You know?
Go for it.
Okay, sure. So you pull up that. I'll pull up my thing.
Oh, God. What's that guy's name? The guy with the piano music in the background?
If you can read it. If you know how to say his name.
Giuseppe Spernini? I think that's how you
something
pronounce
like
it.
Either way, whatever. It's fine.
Something like that. So John's going to pull up the ambient noise. I'm going to pull up the actual piano music. But here's how speed dating works. Speed dating. We speed date each other, acting out as different characters in a speed dating environment. So it's usually a restaurant called Jean Jay is what we've been calling it. It's a joke from one of our shows. John came up with it. And basically, we have a good, solid... Let's time it this time, yeah?
Yeah.
Let's be professional about it. Two minutes.
2 minutes?
Do you want to go overtime? Is everyone
sure.
okay with
How
that?
How many sessions do you want to do? Because I don't have that many people in my head, I'm going to be honest.
I mean,
I don't have that many either, but we have a lot of people in here.
I mean,
so
we can do different
each
genders for each person, so I can definitely think of like 3 to 5 personalities
okay.
of one gender. And then
Ooh,
we have.
Look at you. Fancy,
so
fancy.
2 minutes
no,
each.
2 minutes each. I feel like that's not enough, but okay.
We'll have to try.
Okay.
All right.
Two minutes each. I'm cutting this off right here. All right.
Cue up the song then.
Ready? You guys remember this. Ready?
I'm not doing
meow,
it.
Meow, 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 meow. Wow, I'm the only one doing it. Thanks.
Meow, meow, meow.
There we go.
Meow, meow, meow.
I remember. I mean, the last time we did it, YouTube like muted our audio because of copyright.
That's right. Our singing was way too good.
It was. I don't know how we weren't. The music wasn't playing, but we were just. Oh my! It was dumb. Whatever.
That's hilarious.
Yeah. Yeah, that happened. That happened.
It was.
Moving on, so this is the music. Go ahead and cue it up. We're going to talk amongst ourselves for a bit, and then I'm sure the owner of the restaurant will introduce them himself.
So we will return. Hello everyone, this is your waiter, Jean Jay, and welcome to my 5-star restaurant, Jean Jay, and you suckers are here because you guys can't get a real partner. So, order my food, pay me, relax, and get ready to mingle with other losers.
Hello, you lovely couple there. Is there anything I can get you for drinks? Welcome to Jean Zay.
Pretty sure he says Jean Jay, not
Jean
Zay.
I was gonna say, I'm quite certain that's not the name
Wait,
of this.
You're the owner.
No, I'm not.
Oh, okay.
I'll just
I'm
take
glad
a,
you clarified
I'll
that.
I'll just take a, just a nice water.
A water? Got it. Got it. Water. And for you, ma'am?
Oh, I don't drink liquids.
So you don't want anything.
I'll take her water.
Okay, another water. All right.
Thirsty.
I'll be right back.
Not the only thing that's thirsty. I hope.
Hi, I'm John.
Hi.
Well, so what brings you here besides bringing
Speed
me?
Dating.
I was
Speed
to say
dating
that.
Brings me here, yeah.
Oh, okay. So, well,
also
the food?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So tell me, what do you like to do for hobbies?
For hobbies?
Yeah. What are your hobbies?
Oh, that's such a hard decision. I like binge watching House Hunters and eating large tubs of ice cream.
Okay.
Petting one of my 7 cats.
Oh, you have 7 cats?
Yep, 7.
Can you name all of them for me?
No, they don't have names. They're too precious.
Okay.
What, this
No, that's fine.
This music is making me a little teary-eyed. What just happened? All right, well,
That took an honest, okay.
Regardless, yeah, so 7 cats.
7 cats.
What do you do, Mr. John?
I'm a professional Dota 2 player.
Really?
Yeah.
How exciting.
I'm actually not professional. I just play video games for a living.
So do you have a real job?
I work at a coffee house.
So do you have a real job?
Well, hello. I have your drinks here.
Thank you.
Sir, a water for you.
Yep.
And ma'am? Sir, your other water.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank
I don't drink
bye-bye.
Liquids. Yep.
Man, that's some quality water.
Yeah.
Oh.
But.
Sorry. I had to do something real quick.
What, zip up your fly? Was
yeah,
that it?
Yeah, that was it.
Yeah, I noticed. It's a
little I let the dogs out.
What you call them?
Yeah, I have new, more than, whatever.
Are they called Shih Tzus?
What? Well, what I do for my hobbies, I work and I like to play video games. And I don't have, once I get my own place, I'm probably going to get a dog or two, maybe a cat.
Oh, I already have 7.
Okay.
We can make it a nice even 8.
Maybe.
You don't sound super enthused.
No, I am enthused. I'm just not that big of an enthusiastic person.
You're not that big of a person, I can tell.
5'10 is an average size.
I wasn't talking about that.
Okay, I'm a size 10, so what?
I wasn't talking about that.
I'm an 8.5 or a half.
Listen, I'm talking about your belt size, okay?
Oh, okay. Well, I think I'm a large.
Really?
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed your stay. I'm going to have to ask you to move to your next tables.
Thank God.
Bye.
Well, hello, you two. Welcome to Sean J. My name is Sean J, and I'll be your waiter for tonight. And can I start you two off with some beverages?
I would love a glass of your white wine.
What kind?
White.
Some Moscato. Cool.
Choo.
And for you?
Let me get a 40 ounce.
What? Okay. Okay.
40, you know, old English.
Okay, I'll be right back then.
Well, it's so nice seeing you here.
What's up, man? How you doing?
Pretty good, pretty good.
So what's your name?
My name's Mandy.
Oh, Mandy, it's nice to meet you. My name is Brysis Maximus, you know what I'm saying?
Well, can I call you Bryce?
Oh, you can call me whatever you want, babe. You know what I'm saying?
All right, hunky chunky. What's up? What do you do for work, huh?
Well, you know, I work down in the grocery store and all that. You know, my catchphrase, paper or plastic, you know?
That's your catchphrase?
Yeah, you know, everybody like that. You know, at the end of the day, they hit paper or plastic, you know?
So are we going to be using paper or plastic tonight?
Yeah, I'm going to use nothing, you know what I'm saying? You know, I just give back to the world. You know, that's what I do, you know?
Oh, well. Do you have a thing that you're into?
You know, I got this thing that I like with bananas, you know?
But bananas?
Yeah, bananas. You know,
well,
I like to... I slice up bananas.
Oh.
Yeah.
Do you slice your own bananas?
I have your drinks right here.
Oh, my God.
Your white wine and your 40 ounce.
I appreciate it, player.
Oh, thank you.
So, bananas, right? Yeah. You know,
you slice bananas.
Yeah, I slice them, you know, sometimes I throw them in cereal, you know, in the morning, or, you know, in my ice cream, you know, when I'm, you know, watching stuff on Netflix, you know.
Oh.
I mean, I live with my mother, but, you know. I mean, she's kind of living with me now, you know, she had to move in, but, you know.
Okay.
So other than working at the grocery store, what do you do?
I rap. Yeah.
What do you rap about?
The grocery store, you know. Talk about, you know, plums and peaches and grapes. Sometimes I eat the grapes, but, you know, don't tell my manager, you know, I get fired.
Do you have a rap name?
Well, you know, they call me Maximilian for my last name because, you know, I'm going to be making those millions, you know, yeah.
And how much do you have to your bank account now?
You know, yeah, I mean, I'm overdrafted right now, but... Overdrafted, but you know, no,
am
I'm working
gonna have
up,
to
know.
Pay for your 6 years?
Yeah, you can pay for whatever you want, man. You can put me on your health insurance, you know, your dental insurance. I mean, I appreciate it, you know what I mean?
Oh,
it's all love.
Oh, okay. So, I do perms. That's my job.
Oh, you perm? That's all right. You know, my sister need perm. You know, I got like 7 sisters and all that, but you know, we all got different dads. It's all good, you know.
Wow.
Yeah, my mom got a rhyme. So good, though. You know, we still all live with our moms. You know, we're just taking care of her.
Is your sister your own mother as well?
What? Nah. Well, I mean, there was a conspiracy, but,
okay,
you know, I never
then.
Believed.
Well, that 2 minutes is up, and everyone moved to their next table.
Go ahead, try the line.
Okay. Would you guys like any drinks?
Good job.
Can I have an orange juice, please?
All right, orange juice. Do we have that?
Yes, we do. Make sure you write it down.
Okay.
Sorry, my name is Sandy, and this is...
Mandy.
And
Sandy and Mandy.
Mandy is just learning how to be a waiter here at Jean Jay.
Are you guys twins?
That is so precious.
No. Why would you ask that?
Okay, I was just on.
Do I look like a twin to you?
It is so cute how your names rhyme. Don't
oh,
mind, don't
thank
mind
you. Me. Anyway, make sure you write down orange juice on this on the receipt
okay,
slip.
Yes, orange
please.
Juice.
No
got
seeds,
it.
Please.
No
freshy
seeds.
Squeeze.
All right.
Thank you.
And you,
I'll
sir?
Just take a glass of iced water.
Just iced water.
Yes.
He's
okay.
Very healthy.
Alrighty.
Now we go to the cook room.
All
let's
right.
Go.
Bye.
So, how are you?
Hi. What's your name? I didn't get it.
I am. My name is Gregorio.
Wow, that's so exotic. Where are you from?
I'm from here. I was born and raised here.
It's so cute.
What's your name?
My name is Stacy.
Stacy.
I'm from North Dakota.
North Dakota.
It's my first time being here.
Oh, okay. Well, okay. So tell me, what do you like to do?
Well, I was raised on a farm, so, you know, I herd in the cows, pigs, and, you know, we get the chickens and the eggs and everything. But, you know, since, you know, being here, I've gotten to dancing.
Dancing?
Exotic dancing. It's different from the farm, I know, but it's just so special. I mean,
okay.
Yeah. I've got really toned.
Okay. No, that must sound nice.
What do you do for like fun?
I I like to... Well, what do I like to do? I don't know.
It's okay. Take your time.
I film porn.
Oh, really? I have three older brothers, and they're really into that.
Into porn? Probably filmed something that they liked.
Possibly.
What are they into?
They're into a lot of foreign stuff, like from like Bangkok.
So Asian people?
Oh yeah, a lot.
I could definitely help with that.
Well, my younger brother, he's like 12, but apparently he's been like into it for like 3 years. But, you know, ever since I started dancing, you know, I send pictures back home, you know, just to show everybody that I'm successful. But, I hear he does a lot of weird things with the photos.
Don't eavesdrop. Go ahead and speak.
Oh, hi.
Sorry. I just think that's so great that you can, you know, have such great brotherly
love. Can I just
have
my drink?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So let me see. We have a flaming hot cup of pee right here.
Okay.
And, you, sir, what did you want again?
A nice water.
Oh, that's right. I got a really nice fresh orange juice for you, but a lot of seeds in it. So here you go for you specifically.
I didn't order this.
Oh, no, that's what you got, though, isn't it?
Hey, man.
Now, don't argue with the customers. Sandy? They're always right.
Sandy?
Yes?
I'd appreciate it if I get a flippin' water.
Okay, no fear. Let's go.
Called something else back at the club, a flipping water.
That's your nickname?
No, there's this move that a girl called Poundcake, she does this move called flipping water, and she pretty much gets in the nude and flips upside down, and you can pretty much guess how she gets down the pole. Yeah.
Oh my god.
So tell me, what? So
stage
you're
is
an
squeaky clean, but yeah.
If you're you're an exotic dancer. Tell me, what's one of your favorite moves?
Well, there's this thing I do where I wrap my leg around and I climb up, and because I was raised on the farm, I moo when I come down.
When you come.
Yeah, it's like I go down. That was so funny, but when I go down, it's like, and, you know, a lot of people, I guess some guys, it weirds them out, but there's this one guy, he's probably like 48, and he has like the weirdest beard, and he always wears this dirty flannel. He always throws 20s at me when I move, so he's like a regular.
Oh. I don't know why this idiot over there is laughing.
I mean, he wears the same flannel
okay.
every Tuesday. I don't know what he does. But,
oh, is that the guy over there that throws 20s at you?
No, he seems a bit younger, but he kind of looks like him. Hey, is your dad's name, Bill?
You want to call me daddy?
Excuse me, sir.
I think you deserve a crisp 20.
I think we need to leave our table.
All yours.
I think you need to leave our sir, I'm trying to have a formal conversation.
Excuse me, sir, please stop interrupting the customers.
Who are you?
Oh, I'm the manager, Sandy. How can I help you?
Well, I was just enjoying the moo-moo.
Oh, please sit down, sir. No.
All right, bye.
Well,
That was attractive.
That guy actually hangs out in front of the club a lot.
Okay.
Yeah, he tries to get at Poundcake a lot because, you know, her flipping water. He asks her if she can, quench his thirst.
Okay.
So.
Okay, that sounds...
We've returned with your drinks. Go ahead.
Was it water?
Yeah. Is
good?
There ice in it?
Yeah, but it's not flipping.
Oh. Well, he's missing out.
Are you disappointed?
Add the other drink. Come on, they don't have much time.
Okay, fine. Orange juice.
Yes.
Freshly squeezed. No seeds.
Oh, thank you. Wow, you're doing good. Ding, ding, ding. You guys are going to have to move on to your next people now. Thank you.
It was nice meeting you.
It was, bye.
You should stop.
Hello and welcome to Sean Jay.
Hello.
Would you guys like to order anything? Drinks, food?
Excuse, do you sell tea here?
Tea? You know, no one's ever actually asked that, but I'm sure we could find some somewhere in the back. I think we only have laxative tea, though, but...
Well, I mean, well, whatever really works. I mean, I something big before I came here.
Alright, sure.
Pass it anyway.
Then maybe this will help you. That might be good for you.
Thank you, I really appreciate it.
Can I get a Diet Pepsi?
Diet Pepsi?
Yeah.
Oh, I see this lady likes to watch her food there.
Ice or no?
Two. Two cubes.
Two cubes.
Yeah.
Okay, awesome. I'll be back with that.
She's not a wasteful person. Hello, love.
Hi.
It's nice to meet you. Oh, what's your name?
Manny.
Oh, that's nice. Manny. Can I ask where you're from?
I am from Detroit.
Oh, Michigan. It's nice.
Yeah.
I've been there a couple of times, but, you know, never really made it across the border without being, you know, robbed. But...
Oh, yeah. Really?
Yeah.
Who robbed you?
A couple, you know, people. Well, a good amount of people. About 12, but...
12?
It's the same amount of people every time I drive through, you know, Michigan. 12 people. Same amount of 12 people. And they're all in green spandex and, you know, Timberlands. And
like in that show Arrow?
Not so tight.
That show Arrow really gets me. That guy is so hot.
Yeah. Yeah. I guess. I mean, he's not that attractive.
I've got a thing for scars.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, you seen this scar here? I caught when I was curling my eyelashes, you know. Yeah.
You get a scar from your eyelashes.
Well, I was curling them. You know, there's this little thing that you use, you put over your eye, and
Where are you from again? Mars?
No. McDonald's England, have you ever heard of it?
McDonald's England?
Egg McMuffin Lane, have you ever heard of it? No? Are you sure? I mean...
Do you know the Muffin Man?
actually, yes. He lives about three blocks away from me. He works down at the bakery and there on, what is it? Jesus, I can't remember what it is. I think it's Art Cakes Lane.
All right.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So I have your drinks.
Hello.
Here is tea. It's peppermint, but it is a laxative tea, so just be careful with that.
How long does it take to pass?
I'm thinking about 20 minutes. 20, 25.
Oh, that's good.
If it's been 30 minutes and you aren't feeling anything, let me know. I'll fill you up some more.
Oh, I appreciate it.
And, you, sir, how about, that, you are.
Excuse
lady.
Me?
I'm sorry.
I swear,
behind.
If I yelp this right now, you'll get so fired.
From behind, you look a little, different. So, here you go. Diet.
Diet, right?
Two cubes. Yeah, you can
thank
see
you.
Those two cubes. Right there.
Pretty men days.
There you
can
go.
You take care of my gum, too?
Thank you. Well, okay.
Thank you very much.
Goodbye.
Better than Caitlyn Jenner. Really pretty.
I'm so pretty?
Oh, yeah.
You're saying I'm pretty?
You're pretty, yes.
On a scale of 1 to what?
Well, infinity, car.
Is it?
To infinity and beyond. That's one of your American films, isn't it? What is it? Toy Story.
I don't. Oh, yes.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Well. The little Walkman. That it, yeah. Him.
Walkman.
Walkman. White.
Walkman.
Caucasian.
White.
Yeah. Is that it? Yeah.
I know a lot of white people. They're so hot.
Yeah, I know a couple too, but you know they robbed me as I crossed the border.
Michigan. Sorry. I didn't mean to traumatize you.
Oh, no. I'm not afraid of them.
What do you do for work?
Well, actually, I work for a brewery.
Oh, my God. That's so awesome.
Yeah.
You make beer?
No. I just sit there and I answer phones, you know, because I have my accent. So, you know, I guess Americans seem a bit fond when someone else answers a phone with an accent that's not similar to theirs.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, your accent kind of digs me.
Yeah, well, I mean... We've lost a lot of money because people can't understand a word I say, but, I mean, I still got the job, right?
Wow. Are you, like, popular?
Well, I wish.
Are you, like, famous?
Well, no.
I want to sleep with someone famous.
Oh, well, then you should probably call Leonardo DiCaprio. He just won an Oscar, you know.
Do you know what I do?
What's that?
I'm a porn star.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Well,
oh,
that's real interesting, but I'm going to have to let you know that time.
Oh, can I get a link to your website?
Oh, yeah. Here's my slips. Make sure you go to Camster.
Thank you.
Dot.
No, I'll probably just go in my car.
.gov.
Oh.
Well, I drive a golf cart, but, you know, it gets me from A to B.
Then how did you get here? Well, I'm sorry, ma'am. You again. What did you need?
I needed you to get up and move.
But
it's the last time. It's the last one, I thought.
She's so pretty.
Am I here for a while?
Are you sure?
Can I speak to your manager?
Hi, I'm the manager, Shanshay. Are we going to have any problems here?
Hello, Shanshay.
I remember you. You kicked my grandmother out of your establishment last time I was here.
Oh, it's a shame.
I did?
Yeah.
I guess I did.
You should respect your elders,
and you
want to
meet my friend?
Do I have to kick
my
you out?
My friend was scarred you by your friend last time. Let me talk to her. Ready? Ready? You want to go? You remember her?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I took off my pants.
Mad. Yeah, you rude.
I will kick you out if you don't
move.
Quickly,
yeah?
We'll just go continue our date at Denny's across the street then, right? Yeah?
No, actually, I'm an IHOP person.
Yeah, all right, I'm gone.
He's
I'm
international.
Out.
It's pancakes. International House of Pancakes. All right. Hello. That's the only thing that drew me, but it's the same American food I eat here.
Okay, well, I guess...
Where did my friend go?
Well, that concludes our segment. Get out here, Betty! That concludes our segment of speed dating tonight. If you losers haven't found a partner yet, well, come back next week. Oh, wait, there won't be a next week. Because I'm closing down. Because I'm broke.
For at least a few months.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, you are listening to 91.7 WNEC FM Henniker, New England
College Radio.
And this has been a show called... Whose Show Is It Anyway?
A show based off of ABC's television show, Whose Line Is It Anyways?
Which aired from 1998 to 2007.
As an inspiration, we have taken Whose Line Is It Anyway and made some changes to turn into a radio show.
So, welcome to Whose Show Is It Anyways? Where the points don't matter and our money doesn't matter and the college doesn't really care about us.
And we're leaving for the summer anyway.
Yeah.
Hooray!
So, this is our last broadcast, our show.
It is.
For a while, yeah.
For a couple months.
Thank you, everyone, to listening. We don't know if we'll be doing a show next week. It's not necessarily required for us, but we will assume no for now. So, assume as this is our final goodbye for the summer until next semester, where I think we plan to do this show again.
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah. Depends.
Cool beans.
Depends. Well, we'll find out, and we'll stay tuned. We like this show. It's a lot of fun. We want to obviously add more to it. But I hope you enjoyed. If you guys have any questions or comments, please contact us
at 603-428-2278 or email us at wnec@nec.edu.
Wow, that was like perfect.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
With that said, I think we're going to go to our switch over to
Otto.
Not Otto. Just play a last song.
All right.
Good song.
Oh, yeah.
Do you have a song?
Oh, I gotta think. I've got another show that I'm in this week on Sunday night. Sunday night, I'm gonna be starring in a show called The Anthropocene, which is for a class requirement. But it'll be fun. It's gonna be airing from
sometime in the day.
Yeah, it's 6 p.m.
Probably know that.
6 p.m. to whenever it ends. It'll start at 6 o'clock.
Okay. Well,
gel pens are very painful when you write them into your skin, by the way. I feel like I'm giving myself a tattoo. Okay, cool. 6 p.m. Just giving each other prison tattoos in the middle of the studio. All right, moving on to some music. What's our song going to be? Any idea?
I mean...
I thought you had something.
I'm pretty sure I have something.
No.
I mean, we could sing our own songs. Like,
oh, that's nice.
No.
If I get tagged on YouTube, I'm going to laugh hysterically.
No.
I want to make myself believe
that planet Earth turns slowly.
What is that?
Do we want to play that song?
Go for it.
What is that song?
Fireflies.
That's right. That's right. I just came up with
that. City.
Let's do it. Thank you.
would just stand and stare. I'd like to make myself believe that planet Earth turns slowly. It's hard to say that I'd rather stay awake when I'm asleep, 'cause everything is never as it seems. 'Cause I get 1,000 hugs from 10,000 lightning bugs as they tried to teach me how to dance. A foxtrot above my head, a sock hop beneath my bed, a disco ball is just hanging by a thread.
Come seem to rain.
And that was Christy, Are You Doing Okay? This has been Whose Show Is It Anyways? You're listening to 91.7 WNEC FM Henniker New England College Radio. Shout out to Christy for recommending and / requesting that song. Christy, Are You Doing Okay? So, thank you for tuning in, listening to our pretty funny show, I guess. Unfortunately, this might be our last one. We might have one next week. We don't know. But if we do not have one next week, then we will see you in the fall semester of 2016. And this is John Bay, your 2016 spring semester production manager, saying goodbye for now and switching to, switching to auto.
And this is 91.7 WNEC FM Henniker New England College Radio.
You're listening to 91.7 WNEC FM Henniker New England College Radio.